Adobe released a pretty significant update to Lightroom with brand new color grading controls and an absolutely awesome new zoom control. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Well, hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. Today we're talking about the new October 2020 Adobe Lightroom update, as well as updates that were made to Adobe Camera Raw. There are six new changes. Number one, the color grading tool. We're gonna talk about that more in just a minute. Number two, faster performance. Yeah. They always promise this with every single update. I'm gonna save you some time. Yes, it's actually a bit faster when you're scrolling through your catalog as well as switching from the library module to the develop module. And I definitely noticed a difference once I did install this update. I also noticed a bit of a speed improvement with the brush tool as well. However, like always, Lightroom Classic still needs more work in the performance area, to be sure. Number three, Canon updates for tethered shooting. No, we're not gonna go over tethered Canon shooting, my dear Fujifilm users. Next one. Number four is the enhanced zoom control. I love this thing, and I cannot wait to show it to you in a couple of minutes from now. It's coming. Number five, additional new cameras and lenses have been added for support. This also includes the new Fujifilm XS10 camera. And number six, the ability to choose the name of your catalog at the time Adobe Lightroom is updating your catalog. Ooh. I mean, what's so funny about this is that it's just a simple file rename, you know, like you do on your computer. If you look at what their news announcement, they put it out there like, you know, it's this incredible new feature. Wow, file rename. That's number six. The very first thing you will see is that the split toning panel is gone. It has now been replaced by the color grading tab. Now, the new color grading tool should look familiar to you if you've ever used a video editor like Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve. Basically, it allows for independent color grading of midtones, highlights, and shadows, plus a global control that will adjust the overall color of your image. Something very important to keep in mind, the old split tone settings that you had have been migrated over and will appear already pre-adjusted in this new color grading tool. Across the top, you have five icons right here that allow you to selectively choose what you are going to be working on. So the first one right here with the three little wheels, don't use that. It's too difficult to maneuver the thing around. It's too small. So you can skip that one, skip it. But basically it shows you an overhead view of everything. Really what you care about are these three right here. The shadows, the highlights, and the midtones. And you have one color wheel for each one of them. Then over here you have a global adjustment. So basically any change that you make to the global adjustment will reflect throughout your entire photo in the highlights, in the shadows, and in the midtones. Speaking of midtones, that's what's so great about this new tool. Split toning never allowed you to really have any kind of control or finely detailed control over the midtones. This tool has a dedicated area to color adjust the midtones. Those of you that use Capture One will already know this, so if any Capture One users are watching, kind of zone out for a few minutes. I gotta talk to the Lightroom users who've never really seen this thing before. What you have here is a color wheel, obviously, and you can move this around to select what color you want. Now, once you've selected your hue, let's say right here, if you hold down the Shift key on your keyboard, you can drag it, locks it right to that hue, and then you can adjust the saturation of only that specific hue. It makes it a lot easier. See, if I let go of the Shift key and I try doing it, it's like, it moves all over the place, right? But if you hold down Shift, bam, it locks it right there. So that's what that's about. Next, you can pick your own color. Let's say I wanted to choose the red. By the way, I love this photo. I mean, you know, I was just walking around in downtown Atlanta, and there was Superman standing in front of a liquor store. And what's even funnier is the people behind him. What? Somebody's on their phone. They couldn't care less. Anyway, Superman just standing there. So let's say we want to choose the red in the S on Superman's chest, okay? So what you do, you see this little square right here? You click on it. Now, because if you've been using Lightroom, when you choose, for example, if you go up here and you choose the color picker for your white balance, right? All you do is you click on this, and when you take your finger off the mouse, it stays as the picker. You see that? But for some crazy reason, Adobe didn't do that with this. It's a real kind of switcheroo in UI. So you have one tab doing one thing, you have another tab doing another thing. It's confusing as hell. So let me show you how it works in color grading. In color grading, when you click on the picker right here, if you click on the picker, if you let go, there is no picker. You see that? So you have to click and hold down the left mouse button. Hold it down. Watch this. Click and hold. I'm holding down the left mouse button and then hovering over the S, and then boom, I let go of the mouse button. That's how you select a color. It literally took me about 15 minutes to figure that out because it's so inconsistent with how the other color picker and selector tools are in the very same software. Now, something to be aware of, as you can see, I've obviously made a rather ugly adjustment to my color here in this photo, to my midtones. You see the little dot right here? That means that there has been a color edit. Something's been changed to that category. So here, midtones. If I go to my shadows and I change something, look, have a look at that. You see, there's now a dot here. So that is an easy way for you to see if you have made an adjustment to that particular area of your photo. Likewise, you can reset everything by double clicking on the name. So for shadows, click, click. There, it reset it. For midtones, click, click. There, it reset it. You could also do the same thing by flipping over here and double clicking on each of these areas of your photo. Now, the most important thing you need to know about this entire tool is this tiny little, almost impossible to see, weird looking arrow right here that a lot of people would probably miss, but I recommend that you click on it and you will now get your sliders back. And it's a lot easier to use the sliders by using the slider thing than sometimes trying to click and maneuver the color wheel around. Does that make sense? So for example, if I'm in my highlights and I want to change the hue, look at that. I can do it right from here. And then I can adjust my saturation just like that. That's a lot easier, I think. So make sure that when you open this tool up for the first time, that you expand this out. And if you do it in the highlights, it'll be expanded out in the midtones and the shadows. You only have to do it once. This little icon right here, if you click on it, it will toggle before and after. That's what that's about. The other way that you could do that is this little switch right here, like you do with any other tab group in Lightroom. So just to briefly explain, obviously hue is the hue of the color that you can select. Saturation is how much saturation you want to put in there. Luminance is how bright or how dark you're going to apply this color. And keep in mind that when you're in the little three circles, even though these aren't labeled, these three sliders right here are luminance. That's what they are. But again, I don't edit with those three circles. I prefer to have one big circle for each one that I can toggle. So now we come to blending and balance. Blending and balance, you have these sliders for each one of these areas you can adjust. So what blending does is it adjusts the amount of overlap, of color overlap, between the shadows and the highlights. So for example, let's make our highlights down to blue, and let's make our shadows kind of yellow. What the heck? Now, if I crank up my blending all the way to 100, it almost forces the tool to act like the original split toning tool, because what it's doing is it's basically increasing the amount of overlap between my shadow and highlight colors. You see that? Look at that. Now, a really handy trick that you can do to help visualize when you're blending is to hold down the Option key on a Mac, or it's the Alt key on Windows. Hold that down while you're dragging the blending, and what that does is it forces Lightroom to put it at maximum saturation so that you can clearly see what you're doing. And then when you're done, you can just take your finger right off it and you're good to go. Now, balance is interesting because balance is basically you telling Lightroom what's more important to you, your highlights or your shadows. If it's a value greater than zero, it will increase the effect of the highlights. If it's a value of less than zero, it will increase the effect in the shadows. Have a look at this right here. You see that? Much more in the shadows, but then Much more in the highlights. Shadows, highlights, see that? Now it's time to talk about the new zoom tools. There are two new features added to the zoom tool in Lightroom, scrubby zoom and box zoom. Now, to make sure that scrubby tool works, you need to go into your Lightroom preferences and make sure that use graphics processor is set to either auto or custom use GPU for display, okay? So basically what scrubby zoom is you're taking your mouse and you're dragging your mouse either to the right or to the left while you're pressing and holding the shift key. Watch what happens when I do that. I'm gonna press and hold the shift key right now. Look at how it changed the icon, you see that? All right, pressing and holding down the shift key and watch this, look at that. Look at that. So you can quickly zoom in on certain areas of the photo. How's that for cool? Look at that. Move the mouse to where you want to zoom in so you can really quickly do that. So let's say I want to zoom in right here on the talons. I go, look at that. The next one is called box zoom, and that's real simple to use. So all you have to do is hold down the command key on a Mac or control on Windows, and then draw a box around something and it'll zoom right in. I'm gonna hold down command. See that? You see it change? Check it out. I'm gonna go, draw a box around the face of this owl. Have a look at that. It's not as cool as scrubby zoom, but it's still pretty cool. Now, there is one thing that's a little bit frustrating about these tools. Scrubby zoom will only work in the develop module. It won't work in the library module, whereas box zoom will work in both. And since we're on the subject of zooming in on a photo, note that the navigator has also been updated slightly. You have this fit and fill moved here. You've got 100%, and that's all that is. You just click on it and boom, it's 100%. And then this zoom right here goes all the way from 6%, right, up to 1600. Check it out. Ah, worms. Oh, that looks awful. Another change that's been made with zoom is down here you have two parts. You've got 100% right here. Then above that, it goes all the way to 1600. And then below that, it goes all the way down to 6.3. Well, I hope this video has been helpful to you. If it has, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. And I will see you again very soon in another video. Take care.